What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to a different kind of video. 50 fun questions about your video games to ask your friends. We're just going to do it here together.
Given that I'm the only friend that he has, and he's the only friend that I have, this is the only choice we kind of came to. we're gonna try recording the desktop and just doing it this way. Yeah. But there may be some editing in post. We'll see. Mm-hmm. Either way, I don't want to spoil them. Yeah. So I'm gonna try to do like this right here. So at the very bottom of your screen, there's question number one. So I'll let you take the reins on this one.
Number one, what's your favorite game of all time? We'll go back and forth. You can answer that one first.
So it's going to be a 50-minute video if we both take 30 seconds to answer. So we got to be pretty quick on this.
Yeah.
So you go ahead.
What's your favorite video game of all time? Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
That's
for
my
you.
Favorite game of all time.
For me, obviously, if you've watched the channel at all for the last few years, you already know the answer to these.
Yeah.
But mine would be Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Next question.
No, that works out good like that.
Just kidding. What's a game you thought you'd like but actually hated?
That's kind of hard, actually. I don't know that I ever thought about that. A game I thought I'd like, but actually hated. Watch Dogs. I just looked over and seen it sitting there. I thought I'd really like that game, and I didn't. I don't want to say that I hated it, but I didn't care much for it.
That's kind of a loaded question, because I think hate's a strong word.
Yeah.
I may think of something later on and kick myself for not, but right now the only thing that comes to mind for me is Sid Meier's Civilization 6.
Six, okay.
Because 6 was kind of a...
Well, you put a lot of hours on 5.
5 was amazing, 6 was to me. But there may be something else I'm not thinking of. It's not.
And that's me too. I just glanced over and seen Watch Dogs and I was like, I was really hoping I would like that game.
Yeah. You know, actually, Star Fox Adventures I didn't hate, but it definitely wasn't that fun.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that's fair.
Okay, next. What's a really popular game everyone seems to love, but you don't like?
Only thing that really comes to mind is Fortnite. Honestly, I mean, I shouldn't say that. I've never even played Fortnite. So maybe if it was a different time and I'd had internet and Fortnite was out back when I was younger, maybe I'd had time to just sit and play it like that, maybe I would have liked it, but it's Fortnite.
I think this is recency bias for me, but I have been watching Reiru play Resident Evil 8. Village? Yeah. It's a gore fest and it's over the top. I mean, I guess all of them are like that, but this one just, I tried to watch him play it and I had to turn it off. I'm just like, this is just stupid. They're tearing the guy's heart out. They're ripping his hands apart.
Like Mortal Kombat.
It's grotesque. And I was like, fuck this. This is stupid. I don't like it. But that just made me recently biased. I'm sorry. That's the only thing I can come up with.
It's super popular.
I couldn't watch it anymore. But anywho, there's number 3. Number 4. What's a game that you didn't expect to enjoy but ended up liking?
A game I didn't expect to enjoy but ended up liking. Well, that's weird because I don't know that I ever went into a game thinking, man, this is going to suck.
I have my answer already.
Okay, you answered then.
Diablo 3.
Diablo 3, okay.
I didn't think I would like Diablo 3. Ended up playing it with friends. I normally don't care for those top-down games like that.
But
I liked it in the end, so yeah.
Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, and it's not even so much that I didn't think I would like it. It was just, they're like, hey, you know, multiplayer. I'm not much of a multiplayer person, but really, really enjoyed getting on there and doing that. So the multiplayer on Modern Warfare 3.
Okay, fair answer. Number 5. What game have you spent the most number of hours on? Well, that one's easy for me. What about you?
It's either going to have to be San Andreas. Probably collective hours, I would say Pokemon Sapphire or Pokemon Crystal. God, lots of hours.
You want to answer mine for me?
Killing Floor, Payday. But Payday 2. Payday 2.
Payday 2.
Killing Floor 2nd. Payday 2.
Killing Floor 2nd. Payday 2. Okay. If you had to marry the last video game character you played, who would it be?
Probably Vic Vance from Vice City Stories. Grand Theft Auto Vice City Stories.
What is the last game I played? I have Space Engine, but there's no characters in that game. There's no characters in Universe Sandbox. Oh God, I know who it'd be. It'd be Pocatello, the leader of the Shoshone Indian tribe in Civ 5.
Goddamn.
I was playing as him. I would marry an Indian chief. All right. If you had to live in the world of the last game you played, what world would it be?
Yeah,
it
was
just... Mine is the entire world.
Yeah.
Mine's the entire world. Civ 5.
Vice City in Grand Theft Auto. That's where I live. That's not a bad place.
That's fucking sick. Where is that? Is that technically like kind of like
Miami?
It's Miami knockoff?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you ever had a crush on a video game character? Fuck yes, I have.
Lara Croft.
Yeah. Lara Croft for you. And for me, I really don't want to say, but I will.
You're probably not the only one, whatever your answer is.
When I played Star Fox Assault, I had a crush on Crystal.
So. No, I'd say you're definitely not the only one.
Bring out the furries. All right.
Moving on.
What was the first game you ever remember playing?
Tekken.
Really?
Tekken. Yeah, that's the first game I ever remember playing.
Damn. For me, it is NASCAR 95 on the old, old computers.
Yeah.
My uncle had, I think it was 95. Might have been the first one that ever came out. I don't know. God, it was trash. Okay, number 10. Have you ever pretended to be sick to get out of something you could, so you could play a game? Yeah.
Okay, so I don't know that I've ever pretended to be sick. I'll never forget, though, when Grand Theft Auto 3 came out, which, not 3, Grand Theft Auto 5, sorry. It came out on the PS3. That tells you how long ago. When it came out, I remember it was a September sometime on the PS3, and I was so sick that day at work. I felt terrible. When I got off work, I went and picked up the game, got home, played like one mission, and fell asleep till the next morning. Woke up and like vomited twice. Vomited the next morning. Called out of work, and everybody thought I called out to play that. And I didn't play it all day. But, yeah. I don't guess I ever really called out, but that's
what I'm saying. I have.
You have?
Yes. I mean, when Total Mayhem comes around on Overwatch, mm-hmm. like to this day, right now, as we speak these words, I will sometimes use a sick day at work just to sit, just stay home and play Total Mayhem. That's the only reason why I even play Overwatch.
Hell yeah.
What game did you last complete?
Technically... I guess, I don't know if we completed it, but Five Nights at Freddy's 3.
You know, since I'm here with you, that would technically be the same for me. It would be Five Nights at Freddy's 3, but if we pretend it's not that.
We'll go to Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories.
Okay. I'd have to pull up my Steam to actually remember what I just... Oh, wait, no, Half-Life. Half-Life. I just recently played Half-Life for like the third time, so that was it for me. What game are you playing right now? For me, that's Universe Sandbox, and for you?
Vice City Stories.
Vice City Stories, okay.
But it could be anything. I just flip-flop around sometimes.
What game do you want to play next?
I guess if I complete that, I would probably play... I think Kingdom Hearts is next up on the docket, the 1.5 HD remix or whatever.
For me... there's this game that Ray wants me to play. I can't remember the name of it. He bought it for me. It's on Steam. It's a space game.
I'm trying to think of those games you have on your wish list.
It wasn't on my wish list, though. It's a game that he wanted me to play. Fuck. I'm drawing a blank on it, but it's apparently really good. He keeps telling me I need to play it. I need to play it. I've got it installed. I can't remember the name of it, but it's on my list. I promise. If I think of it, I'll come back. I'll mention it later. In your opinion, what is the best games console?
Okay, I'll just say it's either the PS2 or the GameCube, one or the other. As far as like game consoles, I'd say one of those, probably, for sure.
I would have to go with PlayStation 2, I think. There's just the catalog is so much larger, you know?
The first party games on the GameCube were phenomenal, but I'd say probably PS2. I'd say PS2, for sure.
Okay. Are PC gamers really superior to console players? I think, seriously, probably. Just because there's a lot more skill that goes into playing a game on a computer against people than there is playing on a console against people, I feel like.
Yeah, I'm a console player, but I mean, I can't play on a keyboard, so.
I feel like PC gamers are more hardcore and serious than console gamers.
I would,
especially with first-person shooters.
That's fair, yeah. That's fair.
So, but you know, that's up for debate. So, what's your opinion on Fortnite?
I gave it earlier. I don't have if you play it, cool. If you don't, I mean, I don't just have a strong hatred for the game or people who play it. It's not my thing. No.
I think it looks fun. I haven't played it. It looks like a really fun game, though.
Yeah.
I just think it's geared towards a player base that I don't want anything to do with.
It's geared towards that, and I think it's geared towards, hey, mom, can I get this? Microtransactions.
Have you ever watched a Twitch stream, of course?
Yeah, I've watched a Twitch stream.
It's 2020. Twitch 2021. I think we've all watched a Twitch stream. Yeah. Have you ever streamed yourself on Twitch or YouTube? I have streamed on Twitch a few times. The quality has not been great because my internet's crap, but I have done it.
I flirted around with when I was grinding out to level 100, just making a Twitch channel for the YouTube channel. And, just streaming me just fucking around. Not even a face cam, just me just bullshitting, but I don't know. I didn't do it, but yeah, no, I've never streamed.
Have you ever used a walkthrough?
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Daily.
I remember having the having a book back when Ocarina of Time came out that actually had like the tips and stuff in it.
The Prima Strategy guys or Brady Games.
What's the best weapon you've ever used in a game?
The best weapon I've ever used in a game.
Honestly, it's gotta be the Rhinocerator and Ratchet and Clank up your arsenal? Is it the Decimator? No, it's the Rhinocerator.
Yeah.
The Rhinocerator for me would be that gun's broken.
The Grapple Jack from Tomba. That weapon, it mixes your grapple with your blackjack, and so you can kill people and you can also swing from the ceiling.
Oof. Sounds good.
Uh-oh.
Hand.
Fascinating.
God. Have you ever had to stop playing a game because it was too scary?
No, but there's been some pretty scary games I've played. I didn't want to play them because they were scary.
See, that's fair, because we just recently been playing Five Nights at Freddy's, you know?
It's kind of terrifying at first, but like I said, it wears off.
I haven't stopped playing a game because it's too scary, but I have played games that are scary. Way back, 6 years ago or something like that, actually, SCP Containment Breach.
Oh, yeah, that game's...
I actually recorded that and put it on the channel.
Those old fucking games like that are creepy.
Yeah. Has a game's storyline ever made you cry?
It has you. Has me too, though. At the beginning of Last of Us, spoiler alert, at the beginning of Last of Us when his daughter dies, it kind of choked me up a little bit. I was like, holy shit, that's fucked. But anyways.
When did I got teary-eyed at the end of
Undertale.
Something. Undertale, yeah. God, if you haven't played Undertale, and if you haven't done the True Pacifist run, and if you don't cry at the end of it or tear up a little bit, then you're just not human. That's fair. What's your favorite fighting class? Warrior, mage, or rogue, and why?
Seems like maybe a Magic the Gathering question, possibly. I don't know. I don't necessarily play games like that, but I would say warrior, because I would probably just
gonna go warrior as well. I played as a crusader in Diablo 3. I think that's pretty close.
Yeah.
What's your favorite game genre?
Oh God, I don't know. I
guess mine's FPS, like shooters.
Yeah, I don't know.
Action, I guess.
Action.
Or does it want something more specific than that? Like
action platformers. I don't know. Something like that. That's my kind of thing. Good. I don't know. I don't know if that's a platformer.
I'm thinking back to like Game Dev Tycoon when you have to pick a genre.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Those are topics though, not genres.
That's true.
So I guess the genre would be action and like first person.
Yeah, I like action games.
So we'll go with that. Do you prefer multiplayer games or to go solo?
I dig solo, but...
I like a good co-op game.
I don't mind a co-op game, but I can sit here and like watch you play something, or I can sit here and like you watch me, something like that.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Welcome back to our 50 fascinating gaming questions, part two. What did you have something to say?
Yeah, the game from the last episode. What was the even question? Do you even remember? There was a. What game do you want to play next? It was Outer Wilds was on my list, and I couldn't remember the name of it, but Outer Wilds, that's what it was. So, cool. Right,
moving on to question 26.
26. Do you prefer co-op or player versus player?
Okay, so going back to that question about when I said something about Modern Warfare 3, we would do a lot of like, I don't know, it's weird. We were on a team, but we were playing against other people. It was PvP. I really like that. I like that.
It's team PvP, like Overwatch.
Yeah, team PvP.
Like 6v6 or whatever.
Yeah. Oh, that was so fun doing that. I like that.
I also like co-op as well. Like Killing Floor, Payday 2, especially...
There was a mode on there where
you could
fight waves of...
zombies?
Well, not zombies, but just... They were sending bad guys in after
you. Like terrorists and stuff like that.
Yeah, I should probably get closer too, by the way.
Okay. So, for me, I think it's co-op, but I do love me some PvP because it can be very satisfying if you're on the winning side.
Yeah.
Next, what is the first console you ever owned?
A PlayStation.
PlayStation for you, N64 for me. Great games for both of them.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Ugh.
What or who got you into video games in the first place?
Okay, going back to the question, the first game I ever played was Tekken. That was at my cousin's house, right across the road. They got a PlayStation. It had to be for one of their birthdays or something. And they had Tekken and a game called Air Combat, which is like a rail shooter, which was definitely like, ew, I don't like this, but I like the fighting game. So them, they got me into games. And neither one of them even play anymore. So
I think it'd be my uncle. He was the one that was playing NASCAR 95. Mm-hmm. In his trailer, and he also had Command & Conquer, Red Alert. Mm. So, I was playing both of those two when I was like 6-7 years old.
Hell yeah.
They were fun as hell. What is the longest amount of time you have sat playing games non-stop?
Oh, Christ. I mean, we used to stay up all night and just play games.
How many hours straight do you think we played? You think I played Gran Turismo 2 sometimes when I come over? Like,
well, I can tell you this.
7 or 8?
Some of those endurance races were over an hour long.
Oh, God. Some of those endurance races were like 2 guaranteed 3 hours. It was crazy.
If you did a couple of those in a row, which, I mean, yeah.
I would say...
A lot.
I would put it in... Actually, shit. I did a...
You did a 4 or 5 hour cook-off on Payday 2.
Yeah, the cook-off on Payday 2 was 6 hours by itself. So I would put mine at about 8 hours straight after. Which doesn't sound like a lot, I guess, but
that's a lot. That's a lot to just sit there. I mean, that's a work shift.
Even if you get up to go like take a piss every couple hours. Yeah. If video games didn't exist anymore, what would you do?
Die. No.
I feel like I would just keep going to work.
Go to work and probably listen to music more, I guess.
I would probably
spend time watching a TV series or something.
Yeah, I think TV would take over.
TV would take over.
I'd catch up on a bunch of movies and... Just I'd probably focus a lot more on other things.
Yeah, I guess.
What is your favorite song from a game? Ooh.
I could like be cheap and go pick a song from one of the Grand Theft Auto radio stations, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna say the Tekken 5 intro song. My God, just the whole thing, the first like 2 minutes of the thing, and then there was like an extra 2 minutes. Yeah. The whole thing was good.
Oh man.
Oh, I loved it.
I can't decide. For me, it's either going to be the final hours theme from Majora's Mask that plays when the final 6 hours start.
Mm-hmm.
It could be Hopes and Dreams Save the World from the very end of the pacifist run of Undertale.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
There's lots of good video games.
It could be La Castlevania Use of Force from Payday 2. So many good songs. But I guess if I had to pick one, I would probably choose Hopes and Dreams Save the World from... Undertale. Have you ever wanted to live in a world from a game? If so, which one and why?
God, when I was a kid, I wanted to live in the Tomba's world and that on that island. It was just fascinating to me when I was a kid. I loved it. I used to write we would have to write stories every month based on something, and I would always pull something from that.
Really?
It was like early fan fiction, sort of, but I had to do it for school, so kindergarten.
I always... thought it would be cool to live in like the Ocarina of Time Majora's Mask world.
Oh God, yeah, any of those.
Swords and shields and bows and arrows, cool, Renaissance era stuff.
Yeah, I'd probably take an arrow to the fucking neck first thing, but.
Which video game character do you most wish you were like? That's a loaded question.
That is a loaded question. Do I most wish I was like? Tommy Vercetti, because he don't give a fuck.
That's a good one. I didn't think about that. I don't know.
I just want to run around killing people, but either way.
Fuck. God, that's a hard one.
That's pretty broad, isn't it?
Yeah, I never actually thought I wanted to be more like one of them.
Yeah.
So much as I just wanted to like play as
that character.
Yeah. I mean, I guess it would be pretty cool to be like I don't know. I always like Axton from Borderlands 2, the guy with the sentries.
Yeah,
He's the one I always played as. So maybe, I don't know. I'll just say Axton, although that's probably not true. Let's see. What's a game you've spent the most amount of money on?
Fucking
fuck. Think about that.
Well, honestly, Tekken 7 for me, because I bought, I'd never do this, but I bought the special edition. Came with a statue, all that fun shit. And I bought every DLC at full price since then. And they've all been about $25, $30. So the game was like $120 plus 4 DLCs.
Oh, God.
You know.
Well, yeah. You can guess what mine is, too, because of the same situation.
Yep, Payday 2, right?
Yeah, I've been playing Payday 2 since 2016, and they've come out with, I would argue, 40 DLCs, and I think every one of them is at least about $4. Yeah. So that's $160 right there, plus the base game was about $30. Yeah. So I've put at least $200 into Payday 2, but I would wager it's closer to $400. Not to say I didn't enjoy it, but...
Oh, yeah. I mean, I enjoy the game. It's just, damn.
They milked it for every damn... They just put out DLC like a month ago. Mm-hmm. Fucking crazy. If you could have one power of any video game character, who would it be? I already know the answer to this one for me.
I don't really know the answer to that. Probably just something where I could... Okay, this is cheap. This Spider-Man. I'd be Spider-Man.
You'd just be Spider-Man?
Yeah. That's not really... That's kind of cheap. But
it seems like I said, if you could have one power of any video game character... So
super strength.
Super strength?
Yeah.
Okay. For me, I would choose... I think I would have to choose Inspire from Payday 2. All the characters can have it if you have the skill.
What is it?
If someone goes down, you know, get the fuck up, and they'll get right up. You know, like if someone gets shot to the and like and they're down, you can say like, you know, hey, you get on your feet, and they'll get right back up. It's really fucking cool. So I would probably get Inspire, and I could just go around being God.
Get the fuck up.
Get the fuck up. Who do you usually choose as your fighter in Super Smash Bros., Soul Calibur, Street Fighter, etc.? So, I guess Tekken for you.
Yeah, we'll go.
I already know your answer for Tekken, I think.
Tekken's going to be King, yeah. And I mean, you know, for Super Smash Bros., Captain Falcon. I don't really play Soul Calibur.
I don't play any of the other ones.
I don't play Street Fighter and Soul Calibur. The only one I played was Soul Calibur 2, and this is like a cheap answer, but it was the GameCube version, and I played as Link. He was a special character.
Ah.
I played a fuck out of Weapon Master with Link.
I always played as Fox in Super Smash Bros.
Yeah.
But if I had to choose, I think I'd probably choose King like you.
Yeah.
And in Mortal Kombat, I don't have it, but if I ever do play Mortal Kombat, the most recent one, mm-hmm. I'm too much of a Terminator fan not to play as the Terminator. And I know he's in the game. The Joker is too, actually.
Yeah, he is.
So maybe one of those two. Xbox or PlayStation, choose one. That's pretty easy for both of us, I think.
PlayStation.
It's gonna be PlayStation. PlayStation is vastly superior to Xbox. I don't care who you are and what you say.
Yeah.
What are you hoping for at the next E3?
So, E3 is actually in like a week.
Yeah, it is.
As of this recording, E3 is in like a week. I don't know when this video will go up. Maybe before, maybe after, but God, I just want some new like first party games from Nintendo. I just want something big announced for Nintendo and maybe even the PlayStation. Just something, because I don't know, I'm not one of these people. I love to play video games, but if you've noticed, like, there's a lot of older games we play, and we'll play some new stuff, but it really takes a lot for me to be like, holy shit, that looks really fucking good. I might think it looks good, but that doesn't mean I'm going to play it, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just something that's going to grab me. Something probably from Nintendo, I'd have to say.
It's kind of random on my end. I would like...
Excuse me.
How long has it been since they've come out with a new Gran Turismo game? Is 5 the most recent one?
I think 6 was, maybe. Let me see here.
I would like to get back into the Gran Turismo series, so I wouldn't mind an awesome...
Gran Turismo 7 is an upcoming racing game, and it's supposed to be... expected release in 2022 for the PS4 and PS5.
Well, you know, that we might check that out when it comes out, because it's been a while since we've gotten into Gran Turismo. I was going to say Gran Turismo, but if that's already on the list, then, I mean, quite honestly, me being the homer that I am, you know, I wouldn't mind, like, I honestly wouldn't mind seeing a Breath of the Wild 2 announcement, which they haven't made yet, I don't think, have they? Or have they?
They announced it like a year or so ago, but
they have given no dates or nothing.
No
right?
dates, no footage, so.
Okay, so yeah, I'm still a little behind on all that, but I would like to get at least a date or something on it because I've watched people play Breath of the Wild, and that means we need to get that on the channel as well.
We do.
Because you've got it. We can play it.
Yeah, we can play it anytime. So.
Yeah, Breath of the Wild 2. I would like to get more info on that because, God, the first one was so good. I mean, I haven't played it, but I've watched people, and it's such a good game. So.
It was. I have played it.
Another one of those would be amazing. We don't need another Mario Maker.
No, we don't need another Mario Maker.
Mario Maker 3.
If I want to be really, really specific, I'll say like, and I know a lot of people didn't like the Let's Go Pokemon games, but I want to like a Let's Go Johto, like Region 2.
Oh, you have to another, fucking, another
like,
area.
Remake Crystal.
Ooh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, something like that.
That'd be neat. Okay, 39. Who's your favorite villain from a video game and why?
Oh my God. You have an answer for that one? I'll have to think for a second. My favorite.
Dr. Nefarious was pretty funny in Ratchet and Clank, but I don't think he's my favorite.
I'm a big fan of Cortex. He's like goofy as shit.
Oh, Dr. Cortex, that's a good one.
I like,
hmm.
I like my favorite villains. I mean, I could go back to San Andreas. I like that you're the main villains from that game are your best friends. I thought that was
interesting. Oh, yeah, because it ends up being Smoke and
they're like the
Ryder.
Culprits of everything. So
Big Smoke.
I thought that was pretty cool.
Favorite video game, favorite villain from a video game? Well, Asriel's technically the villain in the true pacifist run.
Yeah.
So I guess maybe that. I don't know. I feel like I'm going on repeat with some of these answers, but
yeah.
I'm kind of blanking on. I should have like pulled up my Steam account and looked at all my top played games. But oh well, it'll be all right. 40. What is your favorite game from your childhood?
From my childhood, we could go. I'll just probably Crash Bandicoot 2. I love that game. I loved all the ones that came out on PlayStation, but I'd say Crash Bandicoot 2 for sure. That game was fun as shit.
I can't say Majora's Mask because I don't think it was when I was a kid.
Yeah.
I didn't really appreciate it until I was older. So, oh man, from my childhood, like when I was, what do you think childhood? When does childhood end? Like when you're like 13 maybe?
Yeah, maybe. I was just going like from my earliest, you know, I could say Tekken 5 because technically I was still a child, but I mean, that's not.
I'm gonna say Call of Duty United Offensive.
Okay. Yeah.
That was even before I had ever played online.
Yeah.
Call of Duty 1 and Call of Duty United Offensive, which was really just an expansion pack of Call of Duty, fucking blew my mind. Revolutionized gaming for the most part when those two games came out, back before Activision turned evil. God, those games were so good. And I played the shit out of them as a kid because my uncle had them on my computer for me. So I'll go with Call of Duty and Call of Duty United Offensive.
Uh-oh.
Another controller. And we will...
Left.
How to talk to a gamer. Are there any games you're really bad at?
All of them. All of them.
Oh, man.
I mean, even my favorite game of all time, if you go to the very first episode of it on the channel, San Andreas, the first thing I do is pull out in front of a fucking car on a bicycle zone. I mean, just, I wouldn't say I'm just terrible at all games, but there's lots of games I just suck at. So, I mean, you know, yeah, that's pretty broad.
I want to say that I was pretty bad at Doom when I played it, because I wasn't doing great, but I was playing on normal difficulty.
Yeah.
As far as being really bad, I don't think I was any worse than the average person, you know?
Yeah.
That's a hard question to answer. I haven't given that much thought.
I was really bad at Killing Floor that time I played with y'all.
Yeah, but you hardly ever play. And we literally pulled you right into Hell on Earth in your first match.
On a PC, so.
Yeah. And you don't ever play on the PC,
That was not controller friendly, so, yeah.
You know, thinking about it, Borderlands 3, there was a question before that asked if there was a game that kind of like didn't meet your expectations.
Borderlands 3.
Me and Ray, we both talked about that the other night, about how it just wasn't that fun.
For as long as it took to make it.
Yeah, it was just like, this is okay, but it didn't.
I haven't actually played
it. Blow either of our minds. Have you ever seen somebody get really angry when they lose? Yes, I have.
Me. I mean, I can get pretty fucking mad after a certain point. I'm pretty calm for the most part, but, you know, 5, 6, 7 tries at something. I've never broke a controller, let me put it that way.
I was in my uncle's trailer. This was probably circa 2008 or 9.
Mm-hmm.
He was playing Call of Duty United Offensive online. And I remember he got killed, and I was standing next to the table. He grabbed his mouse and slung it through the window in his kitchen.
Oh,
and it went out into the yard. The window was closed, by the way.
Oh, God.
I'll never forget that.
So I'll just answer this one. I said me, but that's not fair.
Me.
My old college roommate. You know him.
TB?
Yeah. Oh, my God. I will never, ever forget this. He's the one that got me hooked playing Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. He would lose, or it would lag, and he would miss a shot and get killed. This motherfucker
slammed
4 PS3 controllers in a week one time. I'm not kidding you. We would have to leave and go buy them, and he bought 2 at one time. Broke like the fourth one, and he had 1 left. And I said, I wouldn't break that if I was you. And I mean, he's got a lot of money, but still, I mean, this is $50 a controller here, so brand new. He had them taped up. They were just broken. Yeah, he would break the fuck out of controllers.
I wonder if he's still like that.
Probably.
Probably. Yeah.
Probably.
Oh, man. What's your favorite game series of all time?
Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, God. That's a good one. I might have to say Grand Theft Auto too.
I guess I could, because...
Not two.
I've never played, like, the first... I never played the ones on PlayStation. The first ones, you know, I played were on the PS2, and I've played them throughout. So, I mean, if you want to go all the way back, I could say Tekken, because I have played all those. So, and I have played all the Pokemon games.
Yeah.
You know, something like that. But they're all three of those. I mean, hell, they're all good. Favorite? We'll say Pokemon. I probably put the most hours on that series. Yeah.
I think I might actually have to go with Grand Theft Auto as well. Mm-hmm. Like, just because of how fucking good they were.
Yeah.
I can't think of anything else. I can't think of a series that's more than two games.
I love it.
And I don't want to just say, like, Killing Floor 1 and Killing Floor 2.
Yeah, I love that the Grand Theft Auto, especially the ones on PS2, were, like, all tied in together somehow.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly due to the mafia. But
I mean, how it works. It's a staple.
Mm-hmm.
What's more important, action or story? That depends on what type of game you're trying to make.
Yeah, I mean, they're both pretty important, but I will say this, action. I like a good story, but I don't have to watch 20 minutes of a cutscene or something. Or, you know, not 20 minutes, but sometimes cutscenes can just be okay.
I feel like this question is kind of unfair because it really doesn't. It depends on what type of game you prefer.
Yeah, it really does. I like a really good mix.
You know, like
certain
games tell a really good story and don't have a lot of action.
Yeah.
And some of them are the exact opposite, where it's just guns blazing the whole time.
Exactly. You
know? I would say, I would personally,
a healthy mixture.
I would say story personally, but action probably is more popular. So
I want a good story, but I also want to play. So.
Is there a game that is considered to be really bad, but is your secret guilty pleasure?
Considered to be really bad, but is a secret guilty pleasure.
Something that you like that everyone else is like, that's terrible. How do you like that? I know that I watched Rayru play No Man's Sky, and it was absolutely trash when it first came out.
Yeah.
But it's gotten better since then, and it's a really cool looking game. I like it, but I don't know if it's my guilty pleasure or not.
Yeah. That's a weird question. I don't know. I don't know. I can't really sit here and think of a game that was just...
It came out and it was kind of like trash.
It was just bad, yeah. I'm trying to think. I don't even know if I have an answer for that one, honestly.
I mean, there are some older, like, N64 games that came out that people were like, oh, this is terrible. And there's some GameCube games, too, that came out that just didn't get well-received.
Mm-hmm.
But, like... You know,
I can just say, you know, as a repeat, but like the Tomba 1 and 2 were not very well received at all in regards to sales. Like, the sales were terrible on them, but they were like cult classics later on.
Yeah.
So, but if you showed somebody that a clip of that game and it's like, you like that game, and what the fuck's fun about that? So,
it doesn't have a lot of visual appeal right at the beginning.
So, you know.
That's a tough question.
That is a tough question.
If you could have any video game character as your best friend, who would it be?
Carl Johnson. No, that's...
Hey, CJ.
What up, Jeffrey? I think a fun best friend would be Link. Just run around with him all the time.
Link?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Get into a lot of shit with Link, but... I mean...
Oh, God, That's a tough question, too. Fuck me. I don't really know. Video game character as your best friend. I don't know. Alex Mew, I think, or Mew from Prey was fucking cool as hell. God, that was such a cool game. I almost want to say that. I think his name was Alex Mew, or maybe it was... I can't remember. The main character you play as in Prey, he was fucking cool. I really liked him. So, I might go with that, just because that's another fucking underrated game that I can't recommend enough, is Prey. But, that's another tough question. God, these questions are tough.
Yeah, especially towards the end, are kind of really hard.
If you could marry any game character, who would it be?
Lara Croft. Again.
Fuck. If you could marry any game character. Tifa Lockhart. Why not? Would you rather have loads of time to play games, but only be able to buy two games a year, or be able to buy loads of games, but never have much time to play them?
That's what I'm doing now.
Yeah, I think both of us are already in the latter situation right
now.
Yeah,
there. I mean,
look at all these games stacked up next to me right here. You've got like 30 games right here next to where I'm sitting, and none of them are open hardly.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not, you know, we're not rich by any means, but if I want to buy a video game, I can go buy it, and... I work so much that I don't have time to play it
between,
a lot of
between work and having to, you know, raise your kid and all the other obligations mm-hmm. you have with, like, being a homeowner and all that crap, you don't have a lot of time. It's like when you, like, you're like me, sometimes when you sit down and you have time to play, you just want to fucking go to sleep.
Oh my God, that's
just
that,
like, God, I'm so tired.
It's the worst thing in the world.
You can't force yourself to sit up and play a game because it's just like, man, I just want to lay down, you know?
So instead I buy a $300 TV mounted on the wall, I just lay there.
God, I think I would rather be the first one.
Yeah.
I would rather at least be able to enjoy two games than not enjoy all the games.
Yeah, exactly. That would be a better problem to have.
So, yeah, we'll go with that. In your opinion, what is the worst game of all time that you've played?
Oh my God, the worst game I've ever played.
I remember a game I played that I didn't like at all.
What was that?
And it was Quantum League with Reiru.
There's a video of that on the channel.
It fucking sucked ass, and I sucked ass at it, and I didn't like it at all. I just played it because he wanted me to, and ugh, I hated it. I don't think that's the worst game of all time that I've played. I may have played something worse than that, but I can't think of anything else at the moment.
The worst game I've ever played. I'm, like, trying to dig really deep
here. Oh, actually, fucking SWAT 4 was ass as well. I played one of the, like, I'm like, this is the fourth SWAT game in the series? Good Lord, what were the previous three like? It was terrible. God, ugh. I cannot recommend enough not to ever play SWAT 4 and probably none of the ones before that. I played that with a friend, too, and it was trash. And I also played this other game called Reloaded the other night that a friend of mine recommended. It's called Reloaded, I think. Or it's called Unloved. I'm sorry. That was terrible as well. I'm really splurging on games that I've played lately that I don't like.
It's a good thing you are, because I really can't think of just a game that I was like, oh my God, this game sucks.
I mean, did you actually like The Last of Us Part 2?
I only played up till... Spoiler, 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 spoiler. I only played up until Joel got killed, and I was so mad I didn't turn it back on.
Dude, I've heard that it's like it's a really mixed bag of, like, people either fucking hate it because of the shit that it throws at you over and over again, or people love it.
I can tell you right now, it's a
hand-in-hand thing.
I did end up watching somebody, and if I had played through that whole game and got that ending, I would have been pissed. And there's no, like, multiple endings. There's one ending, and if I had got that ending, I would have been like, did I really just sit through this because... This is terrible.
Yeah. I don't think I ever actually want to play The Last of Us Part 2 just because I know of how it goes, and it just sounds like...
I don't want to say that's the worst game of all time, because it is like it's a good game, but oh my God, I would have been pissed if I... I mean, I'm not saying I would never turn it back on and just play through it for the hell of it just to fuck around, but... Yeah, I would have been pissed.
Did you ever play, like, any, like, really shitty Walking Dead game that came out that was just terrible? Like, I know Telltale put one out that was good, but there was another one that came out that was terrible.
It was called The Walking Dead Survival Instinct. And let me tell you, at the time it came out, my love for that series was, like, through the roof. So it could do no wrong. But if you go back and play that, it was so bad. It was so rushed. So, yeah, I'm glad you said that, actually.
That's not the one that Overkill made, though, is it?
No, this was Activision rushed this shit out. There you go. That's the problem. Last question, though, right here.
Last question. Would you give up video games for life and receive $500,000 in cash, or would you refuse the money?
Yes, in a heartbeat. in a New York
to
fucking
to which one? I would refuse the money.
You'd refuse it? Oh, I'd give them up. I could sit here and watch somebody play a video game.
I don't feel like $500,000 would last me the rest of my life. I don't feel like...
It wouldn't last me.
I don't feel like I'm struggling enough for money at all right now to even think about needing to take that. Like, I'm doing fine right now financially. But when I think about games like Prey and Majora's Mask and Undertale and, you know, games that I have played that when I get done playing them, I'm just like, wow, that was really good. Fucking amazing.
Yeah.
I don't want to miss out on the chance to ever feel that again.
Yeah, that's fair.
But I mean,
I could crawl my way out of some debt though with 500 grand.
But with 500 grand, you could probably take care of your family for the rest of their lives. Or if you invested it properly, you could send your kid to school debt free.
I could pay my house off.
You could pay your house off.
And still have quite a bit left.
Yeah, I mean, so, but I don't have any of those responsibilities personally. So that's the difference between that. And I think that's it, huh?
Yeah, are you chatting about video games?
Questions and answers.
Things they people sent in. What is that? I want to play
a game online with my 6-year-old kid, but I want us to play together versus other, as in a turtle game in the 90s, as an example. What? I don't give a crap about your kids. Anyways, So here we go. Thank you, Level Skip, for this really cool 50 questions.
I don't even know how I found this
thing. Yeah, I don't know how you found it either.
I have no idea, but it was fairly new. I mean, it came out 2021 this year, so yeah. I was like, man, this would be like a fun, quick couple video or two to make just to answer some questions.
Kind of, it kind of also
makes you think.
It's more of a personal connection for us to any like people that are watching.
Exactly.
Just to give you a little more insight about how we think and what we prefer and stuff like that.
Exactly. Really fun, though.
Yeah, I'm glad we did it. And who knows, we may end up doing more stuff like this in the future if we find things that look appealing and have kind of the same dynamic about them. You never know.
Absolutely.
But either way, this was pretty fun. Hope you enjoyed.
Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you so much for watching.